Hey, what's up, dudes? Kublai Khan here, and I don't hunt cougars. Gus, say hi!
I don't hunt cougars either. They hunt me.
Well, that's the idea, man. You sexy young lad. Of course you're gonna be hunted by those sexy cougars.
I've only been hit on twice by random people, and they were both cougars.
Nice! Oh, I opened the door.
Well, the first one was back when I played at a band's. We were playing a show in Milwaukee.
Oh, gotcha.
And we got to the venue pretty early. Like, the show started like 8, and we got there like 5:30, and we just hung out. And I was talking with the woman who was running the show.
Yeah.
And she kept offering me drinks and stuff. But at the time, I was,
ooh,
I think I was 19.
Yeah.
So I couldn't drink.
Right.
But that didn't stop her at all. So she just kept going all night. Oh, I got a weapon.
Oh, goddammit. You're my shadow right now. I was like, how are these opening without me pressing the button? And then
yeah,
you got the gun.
So ooh, by what? The end of the night, it was like a 6-band show.
Yeah.
So it was quite a long one. And, excuse me. And, like, we were loading up and we were heading off because we had a 6.5-7 hour drive back to Fort Wayne. And we were like, hey, you know, thanks for having us for the show. We were talking with her and some of the other bands we played with. And I walked over to her and was like, hey, thanks for setting the show up and having us come out and play. And she's like, no problem. You guys were great. Oh, you were the best band all night. Like, she was
just a little
shit-faced. And I was like, okay, well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. And she just looks at me, like, straight in the eye, just complete eyes-locked contact, which is a phrase now, apparently. And she just goes, you have the prettiest eyes. Thank you. Yeah, we gotta get going. Oh, do you have to go? You're so nice. Yeah, we have a 7-hour drive. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Come back sometime.
Aw, that's so nice. Oh, I completely messed up to set the timer again.
That's fine.
What was the second time you were hit on?
The second time was sexy's a bit of a stretch.
Well, cougar.
Well, the first lady was pretty cute.
Yeah.
So. But this one, I was on vacation with my family in Washington, D.C. This was early June this year.
Gotcha. I like vacation with my family. I'm like, oh, this is going to be a good cougar story.
And we're at a hotel, and the hotel didn't have, like, a breakfast or anything.
Yeah.
So there's a CVS next door. So we would go to this. We went to the CVS the night before, just grab a few things. It's like some sandwich, like a sandwich or some milk or cereal or something.
Right.
And we walk in there, and there's this woman in a big, like a big, I don't think it was actual fur, but a big fuzzy long coat.
Uh-huh.
Like, it kind of looked like the one Cruella de Vil wore in 101 Dalmatians.
Nice.
She had a, like a wheelie suitcase and a big fluffy hat with the tag still on it.
Uh-huh.
It's
the new sticker still on thing.
Yeah, kind of, but it was like the tag, like that little plasticky bit.
Yeah.
Still on there, and the cardboard tag, it was just still on there.
Huh. It's kind of ridiculous.
She was looking at, like, they had, like, flavored breads, like blueberry and banana bread and stuff.
Okay.
So, I'm walking past her, because I was going to go look at breakfast sandwiches. And she, I was like, excuse me. I was like, she's in my way. So I was like, oh, excuse me. Ma'am? And she just says, oh, bonjour, big guy. And it's just like, hi. You mind if I skip by? And she's like, oh, of course. And I walked by, and I'm like, okay. I go get my sandwich and get a drink. And we're in there for a while, because just looking around for things. My mom's on a pretty strict diet. My sister is gluten intolerant. My dad's a vegetarian, so we're in there for a while just looking for
what you can feed on.
Yeah, I mean, I'll eat whatever, so I actually just started doing a diet this week, so.
Gotcha. Well, good luck to you, and let me know if you want me not to talk about delicious foods.
Oh, I'm fine with delicious foods. This is the day after I ate the fried Oreos since the diet started.
Gotcha.
So we're good there. And about 10, 15 minutes later, we're leaving the store, and I look down the aisle, and that woman, the cougar who hit on me, was still just staring at the bread. It was a bit weird.
Kind of like this guy staring at the fan.
If you do not act. Because I'm not what most people consider your average attractive male. I am tall, hairy, and pretty fat, so...
Hey,
but
man.
I got the beard.
Got the beard, and you know that the line, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. It's true. Now, don't get me wrong, being thinner tends to correlate with being more sexually fit in the evolutionary standpoint. So yeah, typically people will find someone who is thinner more attractive, but that doesn't necessarily always line up.
Yeah. Now, I've been told by several friends and stuff that's like, they always say, like, you're very handsome or you have a cute face. Like, it's never a thing about my body, so.
It's, you gotta understand that a lot of people are afraid to hurt people's feelings when people are very obviously aware of what their body looks like.
Oh, I'm well aware of that, and yeah. I'm totally fine with that. I know I don't have the most traditionally attractive body.
I like how you're like, and it's very attractive. I was just like, oh, that's funny, man. Because a lot of people are, like, so scared to say anything positive about themselves, too. So I like how you're adding it. You're just like, I'm going to fuck up as many camps as possible. Focus on the fucking. Wink, wink, ladies. And men.
Well, what matters is my girlfriend Caitlin thinks I'm attractive, and that's who I really only care who thinks I'm attractive.
And that's very true. Like, that's
she's the one I'm in love with, she's the one I'm sleeping with. I don't care what random people think.
That's pretty much the truth there. I completely agree. It's like, though, I mean, I'm going to still support you if you want to, like, lose weight and stuff, because it's like, technically, it's much healthier to do that.
Oh, yeah, totally, yeah. I'm not doing it I'm not losing weight for a body image thing. I'm losing weight because I'm overweight, and I want to live to be, like, 70 or 80 at least.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, you want to do our golden keys real quick?
I'll do one.
Oh, yeah, I'll do one, too. I actually have another one from some other time.
Because I think I got 7 right now, because at this level, it's kind of easy to get
things once again, better.
Also, we get 2 of everything, so... Because you got 2 grenades there.
Yeah.
And if I get, like, 2 pistols or something.
Oh, you mean we could share?
Yeah.
Oh. Hey, could I take the assault rifle?
Go for it. I was going to go for the SMG.
Gotcha.
And I'll take one of those grenades.
Yeah, let me share that with you too. At a friendship, on the friendship lollipop, it's a good trip to the candy stop.
Candy.
Boop. There you go.
There goes that's a home run. She went flying.
Yeah, I'm gonna go chat with Zed real quick. But
it's way better than what I had.
It's my this one I just picked up is way better too, but it's not fireworks, which is a bit disappointing. Zed, I want to eat your
babies. Son, Zed, I think is one of the coolest voices.
Son, disgusting bit. I love the do no harm thing is like in that.
Yeah, I freaking love the splash like title card things they have in Borderlands.
It's pretty good, yeah. Like they definitely fit.
Yeah.
Man, this like, assault rifle is crazy powerful.
Like, the one complaint I have was, there's an enemy later on, because of your jumbled way of playing Borderlands 2.
Yeah.
I don't know if you ever saw him, it's this big Hyperion robot called Saturn.
Uh-huh.
Who just kind of just shows up out of nowhere.
Yeah.
And, boom, 3 weapons.
Oh, nice, man.
Oh, I just sold my pistol.
Oop, bye, she back. Oh, I have to hit the button to get me 3 weapons, don't I?
You should have it now. Just go back.
Oh, there
to
it is. Yeah, it wasn't loading, so it was in the menu when it happened.
Yeah. But yeah, like Saturn is a cool little boss fight kind of nowhere. But I saw a really funny thing on Reddit where someone said he should have a splash screen that says "Prepare Uranus."
I like that. That's very good. Prepare Uranus. Oh man. Doctor I had more the subject to talk about when we were talking about, like, oh wow, this gun is crazy good looking.
I actually got a kind of a interesting story going back to Cougar Hunter.
Yeah.
About the actual specific show.
Uh-huh.
That was my, I think it was my fifth or sixth time seeing Cougar Hunter.
Gotcha.
And I know their guitar player.
Yeah.
So I go check him out. And it was at the Three Rivers Festival.
Uh-huh.
It's a big outdoor thing. And it was rain. It's been storming a lot out here. Been very wet, very rainy.
Uh-huh.
Not very fun. And it was raining pretty hard in the morning. But oh, hey, do you want to help me perform surgery real quick?
Oh yeah. Hold on. Doctor, let me get you the scalpel.
Wait, you do have the scalpel.
I do have the scalpel. All right.
Just perform surgery on this fine gentleman.
Okay, hold on. I'm an intern, so this is my first time doing surgery. Oh, God, I didn't use the scalpel at all. I'm sorry.
I didn't know you could do that. You just jumped on him and he died. Did you didn't melee him, did you?
No, I jumped on his head.
Great.
I'm very bad at surgery. I'm sorry, everyone. I tried to use my feet. I panicked.
Oh, God, he shit himself, I think.
Really? Oh, is that poop?
That or very dried blood.
That could be very dried blood, but I wouldn't...
Blood over here.
It could be poop.
It's probably poop.
I mean, I did just jump on his stomach, so...
Yeah.
I mean, I was very compressing.
But yeah, so we're... It rained in the morning, and it wasn't going to rain in the afternoon or evening. Like, it was getting nice and sunny out.
Uh-huh.
And then about an hour, 15 minutes after Kukuna starts playing, a security guard comes over and talks to their, I think it's their bass player.
Yeah.
And they say, we have to stop playing. There's a huge storm coming. It's an outdoor venue, so
yeah.
Everyone go home.
Aw.
So, we start driving home, and it's raining a bit, and then we get probably about halfway home, maybe a little, like, maybe a third of the way home.
Yeah.
And it is just torrential.
Okay.
Like, I can't see anything. There's constant lightning. Like, it's like a strobe light. And it's just driving through this, and it starts hailing, and... It was a rough one, but we made it.
I'm glad that you're not dead.
Yeah. Sorry, I was just turning in a question.
No worries. I'm going to do the Claptrap secret stash.
Go for it. And then, what was kind of funny was, they're an 80s cover band, so, you know, they play, like, Motley Crue and Guns N' Roses, all that stuff. And the last song they ended with was Shout of the Devil by Motley Crue. And they said it was, and I thought it was actually pretty fitting, because when they said they stopped playing, it's like, okay, guys, the devil's shouting back. The devil's here. There's a storm coming. We can't play.
Yeah.
So.
Jeez. You want to find the stash? Oh, never
I think
mind.
We found it.
I didn't even touch it. Oh, that's right. I have weapons in here from, like, really nice weapons. Requirement levels 30 and 26.
Congratulations! On my... meticulously planned challenges. Why don't you go check out the stash? Have you seen a sign up here as well?
There's a sign?
Yeah.
Claptrap super secret stash. No, I did not see that.
Even though you didn't now, I've got a whole bunch of, like, good legendaries and stuff in there on my,
My
360... No, my 1.
Uh-huh.
So. I actually just traded in a bunch of 360 games to GameStop today. So.
Nice.
Got $91.
You did the GameStop thing?
Yeah, I had a bunch of games that either I didn't play. No, it was only about 6 or 7 games. Like, I didn't play them, or I had them on, like, the one. Like, I traded in the pre-sequel because I had a... The Handsome Collection on the one.
Right.
Stuff like that. And, I got $91 in trading credit.
That's impressive. Like, I was under the impression they just, like, give you nothing. This gun doesn't seem to work.
Kind of. I also had a coupon for an extra 50%, so.
Gotcha.
So it's gonna be.
You got $45 for six games.
No, I got $91.
I know, but then you had a 50% more. Oh, wait, so that would have gotten you 60. Okay.
Yeah, it was 60, and then they gave me the 90, and I just put it all down on Rock Band 4.
Right, on Rock Band 4.
I fucking love Rock Band.
Well, I can see, I mean, I can see, like, the band crossover for sure.
Yeah. Well, Rock Band was what initially taught me the very basics of drumming.
Really?
Yeah.
Like, you learned how to, like, let's see, you do this, like, snare drum, and then every, like, second, fourth beat, and then bass drum every third and first beat.
Yeah, pretty much the very basics, coordination, you know, use your right hand for the hi-hat, get right. Your foot in there. We have a weapon-specific ones here.
Yeah, I'm waiting for him to give it to us.
It's in your inventory.
Oh, is it?
Yep.
Oh, there it is.
I'll let you do this one.
Oh, this well, thank you, good sir.
It's just to teach you about elemental weapons.
Yeah, I remember. I've done this.
Yeah. It's four quests in one.
It's a... Yeah, and you get to play with each weapon type, which I think... This is a good explanation on how to use each weapon.
Yeah, it's a really nice one. I missed this the first... When I... Like, the first time I got into Borderlands,
you wanna do this
I
one?
Missed this one. Oh, sure. Spoilers, he isn't. It's only a matter of time until Jack Burns is sitting to the ground. Oh, there it is. Cheapskate.
Oh, wow, it takes four bullets per shot for this gun.
Turn that in. And now corrosive. That's not corrosive. There's a corrosive. Armored targets
like these damn things. You end up fighting robots at the end of this game, and corrosive is what's required.
Yeah, it's not even at the end, it's partway through.
Really?
Yeah.
Dude, I never really used slag, ever.
For for the first playthrough and even the second one, it's not really worth it, but when you get to the final, like, ultimate Vault Hunter, when you're up in, like, level 50s and 60s... Right.
Slag's super beneficial.
Slag is your best friend.
Gotcha. Switch to another weapon once your enemy has been slagged. I mean, it's out of everything, it's a much more strategic style than like what shock, fire, or acid is.
Yeah. And then there's always explosive.
Right. Well, that was pretty easy to explain.
Yeah.
It works.
Right. And then in pre-sequel, they got rid of slag and added cryo.
Oh, for freezing.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
I actually think it's way cooler than slag.
I agree to that. I need nothing done. Let's see what weapon stuff they have. I only have one question to ask of all of you. I got some cool sniper rifles and the like, but I think I'm not gonna do anything with that.
Yeah, Krieg's not the best for sniper rifles.
I have one, but I'm not necessarily using it.
I might use a sniper at some point. I normally don't, but if you're gonna be the crazy running in melee guy, cause you're fucking Krieg.
Yeah, cause I'm Krieg.
It might be better for me to hang back sometime.
Right.
Cause I also have... I have an ability later on where I can revive you using my action skill from any range.
Uh-huh.
So if I can look at you through a sniper scope and you're far enough, and if I just hit left bumper, you're up.
Really?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. I just did the black market upgrade.
Yeah, I did that too. I got I forgot what I got. I think I got pistol ammo.
I got assault rifle ammo. I'm gonna talk to our buddy. Bully Mong. Oh, that's one of my favorite missions. I'm gonna play real quick. So our timer went up, but I figured since we just kind of walked around a lot this one,
yeah,
that's we can just either. Oh, you won something. God damn it.
Well, then you play again.
But that's how gambling debts start. Oh, nice. I got a green gun.
Oh, hey, I got one, too.
Cool.
What'd you get?
An assault rifle that explodes.
I got a sniper rifle. I was just talking about one of these.
I pulled it off. Oh, that's actually not that bad. It's,
I'll use a sniper for a little bit.
I'm gonna switch back to some of these new toy weapons. There we go. I'm gonna sell this. So let's see. Do you want to just make this an extra long one? Because we haven't, like, attacked or anything? Or do you
want
to do
it
like...
you want to.
I could see it. Let's do another story, though. I'm liking your stories. Or do you want to hear something of mine related to, like, image viewing or whatnot?
If you want, real quick, do you want to just do the side mission? We have the name game.
What's the name game?
We gotta go, No, the side mission. It's not an actual game. It's the quest.
Oh, the quest. Oh, yeah, this is a good quest.
Yeah.
I got all excited. I was like, there's a mini game? Oh, my goodness. Yeah, no, the name game's really fun.
Yeah. If you stop halfway through, everyone's just called boner fart.
Oh, I know. Do you want to just stop halfway through to get boner farts?
Sure.
That's just a good little mission for funds. All right, let's see. I'm trying to think of, I don't know. Where do I go with this? We were talking about, like, beauty in the eye of a holder and stuff like that, but now I'm trying to remember, or I could tell stories about, like, I could tell stories about the cougar that I dated. That could be a...
Tell me a story, Grandpa Kuble.
Grandpa Kuble? Oh, sonny Gus, I'll tell you about the girls when they were fine, not these lame girls that you see today. Oh, man, when they were just looking good, you know?
And it used to be all oranges as far as the eye could see.
Man, money did grow on trees. Is that the story? Is that good enough for you?
And it was back when we could trust the government. This Obama with his crazy weather machine.
He's making it warmer and colder. I don't know if I can trust him.
And those damn kids stealing your car.
Oh, and all this. I always like when, like, you hear someone talking about that. You're like, come down, man.
Oh.
Did I kill you?
No, I just teleported right to you, and you were just doing this.
We're driving back and forth over Bullymongs? That's right.
I remember when this was all a field of skulls.
I remember when I could kill all the Bullymongs in the world and not give a crap about their family or, you know, things like... You know what? Do you ever hear that story when people talk about how they, like, used to do these terrible, terrible things? And you're like, I'm really glad that that's not allowed anymore. But they talk about it, they're like, oh, I miss this.
Yeah.
Like,
I heard one of the, a few months ago where it's like, I missed the days when smoking didn't kill you. It's like, it always would kill you. You just didn't know it would kill you.
Right. Or like when, kids used to be able to, like, ride in, like, not in the back seat, but in, like, that part of the car behind the back seat. Like, under the rear view window.
Yeah, or like the bed of a pickup truck or something.
Yeah. And they would like fall asleep up there and stuff. Or, like kids would never wear helmets. Or here's one. Parents would just like let their kids walk home. Like, I was reading the other day about a family that like, got separated from their kids because they were late to pick up their kid. So they like,
I'm assuming from school.
Yeah, from school. So the kid walked home. And then had to stay outside for, like, an hour. He played basketball. And, like, then a
neighbor... Those damn kids hit an exercise!
But he played basketball. And then all of a sudden, like, his parents got home. But then, the police showed up. And were like, hey, there's a kid who's being mistreated here. And they, like, took him away. And, for a month, the parents couldn't see their kids. And had to go to classes and shit. Because they weren't there, like, at that time. And it was like, holy hell, like, that is so much worse for the kid to pull them apart like that.
Yeah.
Than, like, anything, and, like, not even, like, even if you believed it was bad for the kid to be left alone for an hour. He was 14. Like.
Oh, he was 14?
Yeah.
That's, I was left alone when I was 14.
Well, it's like, it's this new, like, it's kind of like the, here we go, this as we're playing, this will, like, in the next 5 minutes, we'll finish up our talk, but, like, it's kind of like in this new political correctness era kind of thing. Mm-hmm. You run into a bunch of situations where, you know, there's a lot of good that happens. People are now, like, caring about, like, there's a degree where everybody talks about being offended, like, oh, like, mm-hmm. being offended doesn't do anything bad to you. And there's a degree that I, you know, I understand that, but I'm, like, if we're looking at the world from, like, you know, I'm offended when you call me, like, racist, bigoted words, it's like, oh, that's fine, like, there's no reason we can't call you that. It's like, well, that's clearly wrong, kind of thing, like, you should probably, you know, respect somebody in some of them getting offended by things.
Yeah.
But I mean, but that the problem is that what do you like? Where do you draw the line, kind of thing? So you have people who like are freaking out because there's a 14-year-old kid playing basketball at home. Clearly fine, like, but they're like, what if somebody comes and steals him? It's like that never happened before and won't happen now. And the police used to not care about that because culturally it was fine. But then, you know, it's like they publicized stories about it and
Everything's gotten. I think it's one of those things that's happened with the internet becoming a bigger thing. You know, everyone's on there and you just see all these horrible things that most of which aren't true.
Well, they are true, but they're like so they were already happening. Like,
yeah, but I mean stuff like some things are completely exaggerated.
Yeah, well, I mean, well, like, so I'm just a big believer in that the internet actually calmed people down. Because it used to be just like the news would show it. And now the news to compete with the internet has to be like 10 children killed by gun-wielding madman. And it's just like, are you drinking milk? You could be just like him. Like, it's like, it's shit like that where you're like, oh, okay. Like, I don't. Mm. Oh.
Oh. Oh, okay, bye.
Oh, you make me happy. I just make this jump on my own two legs. Nice and easy. No problemos. Oh, feels good, yo. Now, what am I doing here? Oh, yeah, I'm shooting people. Oh, this is taking too much effort. Throw grenades! Yes. Yes.
Yeah, horrible things in the world.
Yeah, so, but it's also, it's actually a big thing where if you are a, knocking down. If you are a day news company or whatever, a local news company, you've been losing sales for a long time. And the only way to keep people interested is by having crazy stuff. Mm-hmm. Or like, more at 11. Like, eating broccoli. Does it give you cancer? Like, and
the studies where it's like everything's horrible for you.
Yeah, exactly. And, but the thing is, it's like because that gets views, and mm-hmm. they're running out of.
It's clickbait.
It is. It's clickbait. But they're running out of people paying attention to the news because it's and people also know it's stupidly wrong, and like designed to just make you scared and stay tuned. But it's people who still watch it aren't actually too much on the internet.
We got boner farts.
Woo! Boner farts. So, oh, that's awesome. And I'm going to go find a boner fart and look at it.
There's a whole bunch of boner farts here. I'm being chased by some boner farts. We got an adult boner fart.
Is that a badass boner fart?
We got a boner fart slinger here.
That's funny. I'm going to check it out. So, oh, man, you're way below me.
I'm coming. I beg your pardon, I didn't do nothing to you.
You are below me, sir. Now I'm with you. I'm gonna look at the boner farts! Boner farts. Oh, it's a boner toot. That's adorable.
It is.
It's adorable. Fuck you, boner toot. Oh, man. So, but the situation you run into is most of the people who still watch that news aren't exactly internet savvy, because anybody who is internet savvy prefers to typically get their information from other sources, typically just reading them, like New York Times or the Wall Street Journal or whatever, because they're aware, one, that the news is ridiculous, and two, you can choose what news you want to get. And there's debatably, like, if that's good or bad, and, you know, in the long scheme, like, maybe you should be given news that you don't want. Oh, I didn't realize there was Skags here. Aw. Now that Skag is dead. But, it's debatable whether that's good or bad about getting news that's either your choice or not.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's soup.
Are we traveling? Yeah, we are. And we can finish just after this. But, in a way, it's like, that just is why people choose their own news. Thus, it's making the local news more ridiculous because they need to keep more attention. And, so.
You gotta get those ratings. You gotta get them views.
Gotta get them views. Alright, I think that's good. Dudes.
You wanna turn this one in real quick?
What was that?
You wanna turn this mission in real quick?
Turn it in? Does something really funny happen when you do?
No, we can just turn it afterward. I don't know.
Okay.
We killed too many boner farts, so now they're just called bully mongs again.
Oh, crap. Oh, well.
If you kill five, it just does it.
Oh, it just reverts it? Oh, I thought maybe you had to turn it in.
No. But it's right here, so we'll turn it in. I think this might get us to level 10. Maybe not.
Okay. Whoa. Oh, moxies. It's great bar, like, and XXX thing. I think that's a really good branding for her.
Yeah.
Ooh. Also, I really like the fact that when you enter Moxie's, you see Moxie's, like, leg-kicking light.
Oh, I see plenty of Moxie.
Well, what I mean is then you also see as you walk in the entrance, it's everything's focused around the bar with, like, the red lights for, like, red light district and stuff like
that.
I think they do a really good job. Insert your tip. You know, like, it's really good branding for her, you know? She does a good job with having her bar. And then they have a broken speaker system in here. Oh, they have an old-fashioned piano. I can't play it, really. What? Did you open the... Oh, you opened a box behind the piano. It's like, did you open the piano?
There actually is a mission later on where you fix this boombox.
Oh, that's cool. Anyway, so let's close it out. Alright, dudes. Like we saw, please leave a like. Visit Gus. He's awesome possum. And, of course, may the ground rise to meet your feet. Wind always bitch back. Sunshine, woman, you sexy face, Gus's fans! Thanks for watching. It's always fun to have you guys here. Gus, you have anything else to say?
I found a stoplight.
Stoplight! See ya. Bye.